I wanted to say that, first of all, I am in support, and I'll be voting in support of this resolution. But I can tell you that, let me just give you an example. The newspaper back home where I'm from, the Rochester Democrat and Chronicle, the Albany Times Union, the New York Times, the Daily News, the Post, have all said that these reforms really don't go far enough. And if I had a dollar for every time I've heard it's a good first step, I'd probably be a multimillionaire by now. And I think we need to understand that, yes, this is a good first step, but there's a lot of things that need to be done. And the people back home, I know in Western and upstate New York, people want term limits, overall term limits on leadership. They want us to get rid of gerrymandered districts. They want two-year budget cycles to save tens of millions of dollars. They'd like to talk about real campaign finance reform and other real reforms to the system. And for some reason, those don't come up. They are not items that can come up. It's not going to be a house rule. But we need to bring the bills up for real reform, pass them in this House, and then send them down the hall to the Senate and shame them into doing the right thing. Because rules can change. These rules will go into effect on January 1st. A month later, they may change. We may add some, we may take some away. But the bills that we author for real reform in this House and then send down the hall to the Senate to shame them into doing the right thing are going to do a lot of good for this state and generations when we're long gone to be able to function in a more equitable manner. You know, there's a lot of talk about a constitutional convention next year, or at least allowing the voters to vote on a constitutional convention. That's going to come up in November of 17. The reality is, a lot of the things that we could do one amendment at a time. Term limits, a whole bunch of other things. We allowed the people in this state to vote on gambling. It got 52% of the vote, but it was a constitutional change. And in the area where I'm from, Monroe County, it actually lost. But we put it up as a voter referendum. 90% of the bills that we author in the chamber here, 90% of the bills that we author in the assembly never come up for a vote. We could have a bill, we could have a law in New York State that the voters could go out there and get 50,000 signatures and put any one of our bills up on the ballot and then allow them to vote on those bills that would ultimately become an amendment to our New York State Constitution. And as the majority leader has pointed out on a number of occasions, our New York State Constitution is four or five times longer than the U.S. Constitution. And we author more bills in this House than they do in the House of Representatives in Washington. So I believe that if we start doing some real reform down here, people back home are going to start taking notice of it. And when we debate these bills that are important to people, they're going to actually tune in and watch us. And I'd appreciate going forward, I'm going to be voting for this resolution, but going forward, hopefully we'll bring up some real reform legislation, and then we'll pass it in both houses and have it become law in New York. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.